at the heart of everything that we do is the scientific method of solving problems. And that is applicable not just to science, but to any profession. The way that a car mechanic fixes a car, the way that a business professional makes a business plan, or the way that a vet saves the life of a calf, they all go through exactly the same thought process. And what we want the software to do is to give you the skills for life, because life isn't about answering a multiple choice exam. It's about finding and solving problems in the real world.
Real scientists don't study problems in a vacuum. And they didn't start off by wanting to teach a concept. They start off by wanting to teach people to be scientists. And you can't do that unless you work through that context. Unless you put real problems forward, you can't expect someone to develop the habits of mind that will allow them to work successfully in that field.
I remember first being asked what I thought about trying case studies with this. Did I think that this would be something that students would be interested in? And I was immediately on top of that. Yes, yes, yes.
The cases are highly contextualized in a way that evokes empathy in the students. And so it literally removes from the equation the why do I ever need to understand this question, which is always on a high school student's mind, right? It's they're very task-oriented, let me get through it. It's not about understanding it. When you bring that empathy piece in, so for example with Clark, here's a baby cow, how cute is that? And oh my goodness, he doesn't feel good. How can we fix it, right? The kids want to do the right thing for Clark and they want to learn what they need to learn to provide that.
It starts out as the game challenge. They see it as a game, but they get so enthralled and mixed into what they're doing, they have to finish.
They are engaged. That's with that many kids, I very rarely have lessons where they are silent. And it's very hard to find things where everybody is involved in what I'm doing. And this year was the first time I had administrators walk in my room and ask me if I was testing, because those kids were so focused on what they were doing that they weren't bothering the kid next to them, because they were in that little world where they were in control and trying to figure everything out.
One of the main objectives of our software is to help students practice and hone problem-solving skills. Now, when you introduce a technology solution into a classroom, a lot of the times the teacher is kind of excluded from that process. They don't really know what's going on. They don't really know how the students are thinking until after the fact. And it was the teachers who said to us, we'd really like to see how the students are thinking. So the solution that we came up with is Sable. And what Sable does is it allows a teacher to see in real time how a student is thinking and how they're performing on various skills that make up the scientific method and problem solving.
Through Sable, I'm able to, in real time, interact with the way my students are progressing through solving a scientific problem. And that's something that when we're doing a wet lab, for example, or we're at the bench, you know, there's an element of they're doing the procedure, but I can't be there beside each and every one of them in that moment to help them sort of conceptualize their hypothesis. But Sable lets me do that.
Teachers, when they're lecturing and when they're talking to students, are always changing what they're doing based on the feedback they get from students. And that's something that we were able to provide in our web tools, is that immediate feedback.
I think one of the most unique things about our team is the fact that we have scientists at the heart of the design process in terms of making sure the science is correct. We have artists who can make it engaging, computer programmers who can make it real, teachers who can make sure that it works for them in the classroom, and we have the students giving us feedback in terms of, did they like it? Did they learn with it? And then we have the objective data from researchers at the University of Georgia telling us whether it actually worked in a kind of empirical way.
Our pre and post test measures are mind-blowing. Kids learn, and not just one set of kids. The most exciting thing that I see in our data is that all groups of kids, however you want to aggregate the data, however you want to look at it, kids are learning very difficult concepts. But what I love is that we've also analyzed the embedded data. So what are the kids actually thinking? What are they actually doing? Because that's more important. If we want problem solvers, if we want kids that can critically think, it's not a pre and post test measure. It's just not. What we see is that kids improve their ability to solve problems. And that is exciting.
So IS3D is the beginning of our story. We're a spinoff from university research. It's one piece of the puzzle. The idea behind Cogent would be a forceful argument in education. We want to not just offer a tool that people will like, we want to model a way of doing things that could change how education is seen in this country.
Your students are different. The way you can use this is different. It does not have to be as a review. It could be as an introduction. It could be embedded in your curriculum. Make it work for your classes, because this is what the kids are going to remember. And if they remember it, they've learned.